Hi guys, it's Nathan from PMTV UK and this is our guide on how to choose the right pair of sticks for you. Probably not these ones though. So choosing drumsticks can potentially be quite overwhelming. When you walk into any PMT store and you see racks and racks of drumsticks, you don't know where to start. It can be very overwhelming. Now, when it comes to choosing drumsticks, the first thing I am going to say is that it is a personal preference. So this is merely just a guide on what might be right for you, maybe what to avoid, maybe what to look for. There's different styles, different lengths. There's loads of different things to look for when it comes to choosing drumsticks. So we're just gonna pick it apart, talk about a few different options that are on the table for you. So we're gonna start off with the most common question to get asked. What do the letters and the numbers mean on a drumstick? So when you look at a pair of drumsticks, they'll have numbers and letters like 5A, 7A, 5B. It means nothing really until you really pick it apart. So the best way to look at it is, 5 is kind of a good size to start with. So most people will tell you to start off with a 5A. Most drum teachers, and we always recommend it in stores as well, you start off with a 5A because it's just a nice middle weight, good size, good length, it's got a good feel to it. Now you can go lighter. So if you want to go lighter than a 5A, you want to look at the higher numbers. So going from a 5 to a 7, then to an 8. So the higher the number means the lighter the stick. Going down, so you can go from a 5 to a 3 to a 2 to a 1. That generally means the stick is going to be bigger and heavier. So with the lettering side of it, we've already talked about the numbers. Now we're going to look at the lettering. So when you look at a pair of sticks, you'll see the number, and then shortly after, you'll notice a letter on the stick. Now, it could be an A, it could be a B, it could be a D. It can be quite confusing. Many, many moons ago, the A and the B used to reference what application the stick would be used for. So A would represent an orchestral stick, B would represent a band stick. Obviously, the lettering doesn't relate to the actual word, so A is obviously not orchestral, but B would reference band and... yeah, so that's why they don't really use it that much in that sense anymore. But the A and the B now tends to split the stick into its own category. So if we have a 5A and a 5B, the length will be the same. So the 5A and the 5B stick will be 16 inches in length, but the 5A and the 5B stick, the 5A is going to be in diameter 1.44 centimeters, and the 5B is going to be 1.51 in diameter, in centimeters. So that basically means the bottom end of the stick, the part of the stick you hold it with, is going to be slightly bigger. So that, but hopefully you'll understand now that a 5A and a 5B, the 5B is going to be slightly bigger and fatter and heavier than the 5A. So drumsticks are made of wood, right? Yeah, just any old wood. Yeah, it's just wood. Yeah, wooden drumsticks. Wow, that's where you're wrong. Because drumsticks have a different variety of woods that they're made from. So the three main woods that drumsticks are used with are maple, hickory, and oak. Now they're kind of categorized with regards to maple being the lightest stick and oak being the heaviest stick. Now when I say heavy, you don't pick it up and go, good God, that's really heavy. It just means that it's a slightly denser wood. It's slightly more hard wearing, like with regards to oak, and then maple is slightly lighter. Hickory is probably the most popular wood that drumsticks are made from. So whether you're looking at Vic Firth, Promark, Vater, Zildjian, all these different brands that are out there, most of the time their main product line is going to be using a hickory wood. So you have three different choices of wood, maple being the lightest, hickory being the most standard, sort of industry standard type of wood, and then oak is the more hard wearing. Oak is generally more expensive, so you might find that oak sticks generally sort of tend to float around the sort of £13 to £15 mark. So let's say, for example, that you have chosen your perfect stick. Let's say, for example, you have chosen a 5B. Let's say you've come into a PMT store, you've taken them out of the rack, you've tried them on a practice pad, and you've gone, yep, they're the sticks for me. Now, the next thing to do, it's a little bit picky, maybe. Some people just take sticks out of the rack and they go, yeah, I'm happy with that. But I have seen it that people will take the stick, and this is how you know you've got the perfect drumstick. Take the stick on a flat surface. If you roll the stick and it rolls perfectly, then you know you're onto a winner. There used to be, it's not so much now, but there used to be a case where you could get some sticks. You could roll them and they'd be like bananas. They'd be bouncing all over the place. That means that the stick is not dead straight, and it might be slightly warped, whether it's humidity or the packaging or whatever. But that's another little thing to look for, is just checking that your stick is nice and straight. So when you roll it, you do the roll test and it rolls with no bumps, that's a winner. So we've talked about the standard type of sticks. Now, within the drumstick world, there are a few little hidden gems that sometimes pop out, and sometimes you might be looking for that little extra in a drumstick. So the anatomy of a drumstick, you know, it's just a stick, that's what it is. Well, now, thanks to great engineering over the years and technology being what it is now, they've experimented and they've come up with a few little tips and tricks in the stick world that might help you and aid you just that little bit more. So we're going to look at two specific sticks that I've highlighted, which are very good in terms of what they can offer. So the first thing we're going to look at is the Promark Active Grip stick. Now, the Active Grip sticks come in standard sizes, so 5A's, 7A's, 5B's, 2B's. So again, remembering what we said before about the 5 and then the higher number being lighter and then the heavier number or the lower number being heavier. So they offer that in the Promark Active Grip range. Now, with the Active Grip sticks, they do actually have, you can't actually see it on camera, but there is an ultra thin layer on the stick. And when you're playing, it actually heats up in your hand. So the bottom of the stick or the butt of the stick starts to become quite tacky and sticky. So if you're a drummer and you sometimes find you have quite sweaty hands and sometimes you're dropping sticks quite a lot, the Promark Active Grip sticks just aid you that little bit more with regards to the grip, because the bottom of the stick comes a little bit tacky, and yeah, so it helps you with regards to holding your sticks a little bit longer during your set. Then after that, if you're anything like me when it comes to drumming, I do quite a lot of rim shotting on my drums. Now, rim shotting means when you've got the snare drum in front of you and you're hitting the sticks, rim shotting is kind of getting the middle part of the stick always catching on the rim of the snare drum. So after a little while, you might find that your drumsticks will resemble something like pineapples. So they're nice and straight at the bottom, and then suddenly they all fan out and you have loads of different like shards of wood being on display. That's where Vater have come in with the Vater extended play sticks. So it's not just me, hopefully. There's quite a few drummers out there that will do a lot of rim shotting when they're playing their drums. So Vater have come up with this great idea of having this almost like a Kevlar wrap that wraps around the middle of the stick. So when you're playing, it just, it does what it says on the tin. It's an extended play stick. So it just makes your stick last that little bit longer, and it just protects that middle part of the stick. So they are also available in 5A's, 5B's, 7A's, 3A's, etc, etc. So they are also pretty cool to look at. If you find that you are a bit of a drumstick destroyer like me, then the extended play sticks might be the answer for you. And then finally, we're going to look at the signature models. So signature models are, again, you might not be so bothered about the how they feel or how they play. You might just have a favorite drummer. For example, we've taken the Austrian powerhouse, a drummer called Thomas Lang, who's a big, huge guy, and his drumsticks are massive. So for someone like me, they're not that comfy to hold really, because I are quite big. But if you're quite a big guy and you've got big hands, not like little fat sausage hands like me, if you've got quite big hands and you need something that little bit bigger to hold onto, then the signature Thomas Lang sticks might be good for you. Available in store, there's loads of different brands. Obviously, like I say, Vic Firth, Promark, Vater, Zildjian. Each of those brands will have an ambassador or an artist that will use their sticks, and they will have a signature model. So it's worth checking that out, because you never know, your favorite drummer might also use the same size sticks that you're very comfy with. So that might also be something to keep an eye out for. Like I say, if you're looking to get your first pair of drumsticks, start off with a 5A. That's probably the industry standard, the most popular stick in the world. Start off with a 5A, and then, like I say, you can go either up or you can go down with regards to size and weight. So yeah, pop into a PMT store and try out hundreds and hundreds of different sticks that are on hand for you to try. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let us know in the comments as well what your favorite sticks are, what you use and what you like using. Don't forget to like and subscribe to all our social media channels, PMT House of Rock and PMT House of Drums. Take care, guys. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.